Thanks, Dave.
Yeah, that's harder than the chair. So why is it sometimes hard to receive? Okay, being Martha means it's about, you have an agenda. You have an agenda. And that's number one. Okay, humility's not there. Right?
No.
Okay, yeah, I think we all understand that. When we have our own agenda, when we're on our high horse, quote unquote, it's hard for, God's got to knock us off our horse.
I think sometimes we judge ourselves, and that's the split. Nobody can give ourselves, can we really deceive?
Okay, through self-judgment, or judgments that we believe that others have put on us. And I'm not good enough, or we have doubts that, okay, what does this mean now? I don't want to feel again, I don't want to open that part of me up. There's different.
For some people, they don't even know what love is. They were raised that way. The lack of love. Sure it is, so.
Discerted love.
Well, in order to receive, you're not in control. There's this open piece of our heart that has to happen. I have a hard time giving real love because
you may not understand it. How it is.
Well, if you have a hard time giving real love, you've got to go back to these.
You've
got to go back to these. You haven't experienced it. You don't receive it. You can only give to the extent that you've received. And if we have strings on our love, it's not real love. My life, I make a practice of giving real love. To win. Do you have a practice of giving real love? Have you carved out capacity in your life to give? That's ministry. Because if we want to become like Jesus, it means to leave our rich place and become poor so that others can find grace. Right? If you want to become like Jesus, it means laying our life down like He did for us. And guess what? When you start doing that, people are going to use you. People are going to misinterpret you. People will condemn you. People won't like you. They'll say you're nosy. Because you're getting involved. They'll treat you like they treated Jesus. Right? Do you have a practice? That's what ministry is. That's what God calls us to. Because that's when it's come full circle. Let's know the grace that has come to us through our Lord Jesus the Anointed. He set aside his infinite riches and was born into the lowliest circumstance so that you may gain great riches through his humble poverty. Enlarge our hearts that we would have a greater capacity to receive you. Break down walls that prevent your love from penetrating and wrecking our life that has nothing to do with you. Wreck the life